Hello folks, welcome back. In today's video, I will show you how to create custom Power Apps form for newly created lists in Microsoft Lists app. So stay tuned and let's go through the demo after this short intro. I am in Office 365 landing page. From the top left corner, if I click on the ellipsis and then I search for the lists application. If you don't see it listed here, you can click on all apps. And then if I scroll down, I can see the Microsoft Lists app here. I will click on it. Here you can see the recent list and then you can create a new list. So I will click on create new list. This will take me to the create list form. I can either create a blank list from Excel or from an existing list, or I can use one of the template. Let's use a template this time. So I will click on issue tracker. So we want to track an issue from the company, so we can create a list here. So you can see this template have the issue title, the description, priority, the status, who this issue is assigned to, and date reported, how many days old this issue is, and if there is a URL, image, or any associated file. So I'm happy with this template. I'll click on use template. We just give it a name, issue tracker, which is fine. If you want, you can give it a description. For the color, I can select this blue color, and this icon is correct, so I will leave that icon. I want to save it to a SharePoint list rather than my list. So I will select the training site here and I will click create. Now this will create issue tracker list using the template. Now, if I click on the new icon to add a new record, you can see this is out of the box list form. As you can see, there are many columns, but the mandatory column is just the issue title. Maybe there are a few columns which are not required and we want to add a title here, for example. So we can customize this form using Power Apps. I will click cancel there. And then from this top menu, I will click Power Apps drop down and I will click on customize forms. This will take me to Power Apps application landing page with that custom form. Now you can see it has created a custom form with some of the fields here. So we don't need these different modified, created by or modified by field. We want the issue description, but we want the description to be a multi-line. So we'll select multi-line and we'll just make it a bit bigger. Yes, we want the priority. We want to add some more columns. So I can click on add fields and then here I can select, let's say if there's a URL, you can select that. Also, you can select assign to. That's it. So these are the only columns I really need for this issue tracker list. I want to add a title as issue tracker on the top. So if I just hold this and put this down and from the insert menu, I can click on label. I will just drag this label left and right to make it full screen size. I will do the text alignment in the center. And the text, I will call it issue tracker. And the font size, maybe you want to make a bit bigger. And also, I want to make it bold. So now you got issue tracker custom form available. You can add assign to person manually, or you can auto-populate this person manager as assigned to person in this column. You can get to that video from clicking on the top right corner to see how you can populate user manager information on the Power Apps form. So now we are done with the custom form for issue tracker. I can go on the file tab and click on save, and then I will click on publish to SharePoint. And then click again, publish to SharePoint. Now this form is published to that issue tracker list. Now if I navigate back to the list app, I can see the issue tracker list here. I click on it, I can see the issue tracker list. If I click on the new, this time I'm seeing the custom Power Apps form for this issue tracker. So we can put a title. So the title is SharePoint intranet not responding, and we can make it critical. And if there is a source to the intranet, you can put the URL here. And for assigned to, I will just select myself here for now and click on save. Now you can see the new record is added in the issue tracker list. So to wrap up this video, today you have learned how to customize Microsoft List form. Thanks for watching this video. Consider subscribing if you're new to the channel by pressing the red subscribe button below this video. Give this video a thumbs up if you found it useful. If you have any question related to this topic or anything related to Office 365 in general, post in the comment section below. I review my comments on the daily basis. I will be happy to answer. Thank you.